lives one day at a time. Kimmy Kim and Elation Radio. They're here to get your day going fine. Kimmy Kim and Elation Radio. Kimmy Kim and Elation Radio. Kimmy Kim and Elation Radio.
And here's your host, Miss Kim Robinson.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord, everyone. I am truly excited. Amen. I am truly excited to be on the radio show on this evening. Before I get started, I would just like to honor Kimmy Kim for allowing me to be on eLATION Radio. I am excited And also, I want to thank just for everything that you have done, Kimmy Kim, for the support, for reaching out and always seeing the best that's on the inside of me and pulling out those gifts. And so I just want to take that moment and just say thank you for everything that you do. It is not in vain. And I just thank God for you. Also, I just want to thank Jerry Royce for everything that he does as well. And so I'm just excited about what everything that God is doing in this season. And so before I get started, let us go into prayer on this evening. Dear Heavenly Father, we just come to you. Hallelujah. We come to you. We thank you that you are God. Hallelujah. We thank you that you are the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. God, we thank you, Lord God, that you are our friend. God, we thank you, Lord God, that you have never walked out on us. We thank you, Lord God, that we can count on you. We thank you for your unconditional love. God, we thank you for understanding us. We thank you, Lord God, for you being near, oh God, to us, oh God. We thank you, Lord God, as we draw near to you, God, you draw near to us, oh God. So we thank you, Lord God, for your presence on tonight. Hallelujah. We honor you, oh God, and we understand, Lord God, it's only by your strength, Lord God, that we're still standing. It's only by the grace of you, Lord God, that we're still walking in the name of Jesus. So, Father, we just bless you on today. Hallelujah. We lift your name up on today. Hallelujah. We give you glory and honor. We celebrate your name, oh God. We exalt your name, oh God. Hallelujah. You are everything to us, oh God. So we thank you, Lord God, for being God. We thank you, Lord God, for you being our Father. We thank you, Lord God, that you're Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the ending, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, that everything that you have started on the inside of us, oh God. We thank you, Lord God, that you're bringing it out to a full completion, oh God. We thank you, Lord God, for the great gifts that you have placed on the inside of us, oh God. But greater is you, oh God, that is in us than he that is in the world, oh God. So, Father, we thank you that you are the great I am, oh God. We thank you, Lord God, that you're great, oh God. We thank you, Lord God, that you're strong and mighty. Hallelujah. And there is no God, there's no man, there's no idol, there's no relationship, there's no job, there's nothing, no money, nothing that can compare to the love of you, oh God. Nothing, Lord God, that can amount to you, oh God. Hallelujah. So we celebrate your name on today. Hallelujah. We celebrate you. Hallelujah. We thank you, oh God, that you are our strength and you are our God. Hallelujah. And so I am excited on this evening. I'm excited. And on this evening, I want to talk about the book release that God has given me. And the title of the book is called You Are God's Unique Treasure. And when I tell you, God birthed this book out when I was going through a heartbreak and I was at my lowest point, God was showing me that even in the midst of your trials, even in the midst of everything that you had to face, everything that you had to go through, it was for my glory. And when I tell you, I had went through a season where I was crying every day because I had lost someone that I loved so dearly. But God told me, he said, sometimes you have to lose your treasure, something that means so precious, something that means so special to you. You have to lose that so that you can find the treasure that is on the inside of you. Hallelujah. So for a long time, I didn't even know my worth. I didn't know my value. I didn't even know who I was. And so how am I going to be in a relationship and you don't even know who you are? And so God had to take me through that dark season to show me who I was in him. Hallelujah. And so I believe that this book
is going to bless people, is very transparent. I believe that not only that it's going to bless people, but it's going to encourage you to let you know that God can take the very thing that you think that you're nothing. He could take those broken pieces and make it to be something. Hallelujah. How many know that God is the powder and we are just the clay? Hallelujah. And so that means that God can mold and shape you again. He can take those broken pieces and put you back together again. I was like the one that was thrown in the trash. I always felt like I was the one that was thrown in the trash. But this is what the Lord said. He said, you know what? I'm going to take those pieces that people that thought that it was trash, I'm going to make it to be something. Hallelujah. I'm going to make it to be treasure. Hallelujah. So I'm excited that God can pick up the thing that is very trash to man's eyes and make it to be treasure. Hallelujah. And say, I'm going to use it for my glory. The Bible says that he chooses the foolish things of the world to shame the wise. Hallelujah. So the very thing that people thought that it was trash, God said it is not so. And I'm going to make it to be something. Hallelujah. And so on tonight, I just want you to know that you are God's unique treasure. And I'm excited. And let me slow down because I want to read the introduction of the book. Hallelujah. And I believe that this introduction is going to bless you. Hallelujah. So let me read this. And it reads, have you ever felt like you were all alone, no one to run to, and everybody you turned to misused you and left you feeling empty and broken? Right now you feel like you are sinking underwater. No one can hear you screaming on the inside. The pain is deep in your life. You don't know how to deal with the pain. Therefore, you look for relationships to fill the void in your life. Then you realize that is not working, so you run to addictions. By this time, it feels like you are barely breathing. As you gasp for air, you wish for addiction. Hallelujah. You wish that the addictions will numb the pain. At one point, your bad habits work to numb the pain. However, now the pain is so deep, nothing seems to take away the hurt. Hallelujah. And now you feel as though you are about to die underwater. No one is there. And right before you are about to take the last breath, you see a treasure box hidden deep within the sea. As you brush against the treasure box, the Holy Spirit pushes you to move forward. While you may struggle to open up the treasure box, you realize God is trying to get your attention. My God. As you draw near to God, he will draw near to you. Cleanse your hands, you sinners, and purify your hearts, you double-minded. That's James chapter 4, verse 8. As you ask God to forgive you for all of your sins, and as you turn to him, he will heal you and show you that you were worth saving. Oh, my God. You were worth saving from the abuse and the neglect. In this season, God wants to reveal his love to you, for you are one of God's unique treasures. You are truly unique to him. He is the only one who can save you from drowning. My God, I'm talking about he's the only one. Hallelujah. He did it for me, so I know he can do it for you. Life comes to knock you down, but God, hallelujah, life comes to knock you down, but God comes to pick you back up. My God, as you open up the treasure box, you find your identity, God, and how you are special to him. God has given you power, and he has given you the keys to heaven. As you seek God with your whole heart, hallelujah, as you seek God with your whole heart, you shall find him. This book was conceived from a series of personal journal entries during a dark season of my life. and it will encourage you to push through the pains of life. Hallelujah. It will reveal your beauty, your treasure, your worth, your value, your identity of who you are to God. And as you give your broken pieces, he will repair and make you whole. God has created you to be unique, and he has a special plan and a purpose for your life. As you embark into this new journey, be encouraged. God will give you hidden treasures, riches stored up in secret places, so that you may know that he is the Lord. So that you may know that he is the Lord, the God of Israel, who summons you by name. That's Isaiah chapter 45, verse 3. Hallelujah. And that is the introduction of God, of you are God's unique treasure. And when I tell you, spread the word, I believe that this book is going to encourage someone that may be experiencing a broken heart. When I tell you, I don't wish a broken heart on nobody, but I understand that some people may have to face that and go through that season. But one thing that I can say, that in your broken season, you can truly draw near to God. And God will draw near to you, and he will reveal those treasures that's on the inside of you, your worth, your value, so that you will never, my God, you will never settle. You will never settle for less. You will always go for God's best, because you know why? Because God is the best, and he has the great things in store for you. He has the best plan for you. And so since he has a great plan for you, you have to go for the great things. Hallelujah. You can't slack on the little things. Hallelujah. God wants the best for you. Hallelujah. And so I'm just excited about what God is doing. I'm excited about this season. And I truly believe that you are God's unique treasure. I truly believe that God has something inside of you. Hallelujah. But sometimes we have to tap into it. Sometimes we have to just go so deep within God. You know, we got to remove ourselves from the crowd and go into that secret place and find the Lord so that God can show you your purpose, so that God can show you who you are in him. Hallelujah. And so I'm excited. Hallelujah. And so that's all that I have for this evening. And so I'm going to end off in prayer. And again, please, also, before I end off in prayer, let me let you know where the book signing will be. It's on May the 27th at the Lewis and Clark Library. And the address is 9909 Lewis and Clark, St. Louis, Missouri, 63136, okay? And that's the Lewis and Clark Library. And that will be from 1:30 to 3:30 on May the 27th. Please spread the word. Let your family and friends know, because I believe that if it's not for you, it's for someone that may be experiencing a broken heart, and they may feel like it's over. But God said it's not over. Hallelujah. God said he's just getting started on you. Hallelujah. It's not over. And also, we do have Peculiar Ministries. We do have a prayer line. And we pray Monday through Friday at 6 a.m. And the prayer line number is 712-832-8310. And the access code is 363-3177. Again, the prayer line number is 712-832-8310. And the access code is 363-3177. And again, we have prayer Monday through Friday. And I just believe in the power of prayer. I believe that prayer changes things. And so we have to tap into prayer every day. That's how you have your relationship. That's how you begin to get closer to God. That's how you communicate with the Father,
It's through prayer. Amen. And so please join us Monday through Friday. And also you can go onto the website, which is www.peculiarministries.org, or you can reach us on under Adija Gaddy or Peculiar Ministries. Let us go into prayer. God, we just thank you for this evening. God, we thank you, Lord God, for you making us. We thank you, Lord God, for you creating us, oh God, in your image and in your likeness. God, we thank you, Lord God, for every broken season, every trial. We thank you, Lord God, for everything that we had to face, we had to go through, because we understand, Lord God, that it's for your glory. And we bless you, Lord God, and we honor you, oh God. So, Father God, we just ask, Lord God, if there's anybody that's carrying, Lord God, their issues, Lord God, we pray, Lord God, on tonight that they will give their burdens unto you, oh God. Father, you said in your words, Lord God, as we cast all of our cares upon you, Lord God, for you care for us, oh God. So, Father, we cast everything upon you, Lord God. And, Father, we pray in the name of Jesus that you, Lord God, will be the potter, Lord God, and we be the clay. Father, we pray, Lord God, that you will remold and shape us, Lord God, and put us back together again. Father, we ask, Lord God, that if there's anything, Lord God, that's in us, Lord God, that's hindering us, oh God, we ask, Lord God, that you remove it, Lord God. And, Father God, that you will perform a miracle in our lives, Lord God. So, Father, we thank you, Lord God, and we bless you, Lord God. Father, we thank you, Lord God, for your love. We thank you, Lord God, that you do not see us as trash, Lord God, but you see us as treasures, Lord God. We thank you that we are valued in your eyes. Father, you said, Lord, we are your masterpieces, oh God. You also said, Lord God, that we are the apple of your eyes, Lord God. And, Father, you also said, Lord God, that we are fearfully and wonderfully made in you, oh God. So, Father, we thank you, Lord God, for creating us, oh God, in your image and in your likeness. And so we give you glory, we give you honor, and we bless you on this evening. And we thank you in Jesus' mighty name. And again, I just want to thank Kimmy Kim. Hallelujah. I'm so glad that God connected me with a woman of God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Kimmy Kim, for all that you do. Your hard work is not in vain. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name, amen.
Showers of blessing, we ask of you this day, then blessing and outpouring, and your mercy we pray. Our cups running over, it's all that we ask for. You can do more than this, so I'm not begging you, dream. I'm not begging you, dream. You own the silver and the gold. Silver and gold you own. The cattle on a thousand hills. And all the earth is yours. Your purpose is so pressing. I am seeking you for a blessing. I will bring you a leaf. For I'm not begging you, dreams. I'm not begging you, dreams. I'm not begging you, dreams. Lord, send down your showers. I am asking for this. So great is your vision. All I need is provision. You can do more than Father will not give stone for bread. How much more with you, Lord? You promised to give your spirit.
Lord. I'm not feeling